الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about animals in the Quran. Imagine this. Animals. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about dogs. We have the story of the companions of the cave. A group of youth, young men, who ran away from the people because the people wanted them to be mushriks, to worship idols, and to leave the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they ran away into a cave. Subhanallah, a dog followed them. A dog wanted to be with those good people. So Allah talks about this dog in the Quran. Because the dog wanted to be with the right people. Imagine this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about donkeys too. Yeah, donkeys. You know a donkey? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about donkeys. And something very, very interesting, that these animals, they love Allah. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't have a choice like us. And subhanallah, these days, a lot of you watch these cartoons with animals in them. And these animals do speak, right? But in reality, do animals speak in a language that we can? We know that animals do speak, but do they speak in a language that we can understand?
No.
In reality, in real life. I know in the movie, Shrek will talk. Sponge will talk.
Donkey
will talk. The dog will talk.
Tiger
will talk. In the movies. But, no, the question here, is that real?
No.
Can we understand the language of the birds? Of the animals? Can we know exactly what they say? We cannot. But they speak. We know that they speak. They speak in a certain way, but we don't understand their language. So these movies you're watching, and these animals are speaking in these pictures, in these movies, you know that's not real, right? Right? You know that's not real. But you know there is someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, made him understand the language of the birds. Only one human being who can understand what the animals say, what the birds say. You see, I don't like to be interrupted, and I already gonna mark some people who are not gonna take that bonus candy. Remember the deal? If you wanna get bonus candy, all right. His name is Prophet Sulaiman. Repeat after me. His name is Prophet. His name is Prophet. And when we say a prophet, what should we say after that? Alayhi salatu wassalam. We have to show respect to the prophets. And the birds used to work for Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam. They used to do some work for him. And they used to be part of his army, part of his soldier, part of his troops. But he had a very interesting bird. I want you to know the name of that bird in Arabic, how it was mentioned in the Quran. Hud, hud. Can you say that? Hud, hud. Hud, hud. Hud, hud. 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 Hud, hud. Hud, hud. Hud, hud. What is the name of this bird in English? Hoopoo. 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 His name is Hoopoo. You know what this bird does best? He can fly over earth and he would know where the water is. He has sensors. He would tell you that there is water behind this earth right here. Like in a desert. What do you need in a desert? You need water, right? To drink. There is no water. He can go and tell you under this piece of earth, there is water. And he eats, by the way, he eats his food. Comes from underneath the ground. He has a long, what do you call this? Nose. Beak. Long beak. He digs that beak down in the ground and eats from down there. Oh yeah. What is the name of that bird? Hud, hud. That's the Arabic. The English. What is the name in English? Hubu. 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 Hud, hud. Hubu. So one day, Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam, who used to be a king, by the way. Okay, he used to be a king. See, he's walking around, checking, you know, everybody. He looked around. Where is the hoopoo? He didn't see the hoopoo. The hoopoo was missing. The hoodhood was missing. He was not there. You know that we recited these verses in the Salah? وَتَفَقَّدَ الطَّيِّرِ. He went around to check on the birds. Okay, I see the pigeon, I see the duck, I see the goose, I see, what else? The butterfly, the honey bird. Where is the hoopoo? The hoopoo is missing. The hoodhood is missing. King Sulaiman, Prophet Sulaiman, he's a prophet. Prophet Sulaiman, what? What should we say? Prophet Sulaiman. Prophet Sulaiman. Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam got so upset and angry. Qala, he said, ما لي لا أرى الهدهد. How come I do not see the hoopoo? أم كان من الغائبين. Is he absent? Doesn't he know that I'm gonna check whether he is here or not? لَأُعَذِّبَنَّهُ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا. I will beat him up big time. أَوْ لَأَذْبَحَنَّهُ. Or I will slay him. Unless he brings a doctor note, an excuse, he brings an excuse. He finds, he can tell me why he's not here. Can I tell you something that Prophet Sulaiman did say right before this scene? Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam was marching with his army. He had a big army, huge army. Everybody, human, jinn, birds, animals, everybody. Imagine this. There were a kingdom of ants. You know the ants? One of the ants, the leading ant, the queen ant, said to the rest of the ants, guys, hurry up. Sulaiman is coming with his army. They are going to step on us. Let's go down into our holes. Subhanallah. Who heard this? Prophet Sulaiman heard this. He heard the ant saying this right away. Because Prophet Sulaiman knows who made him understand the language of the birds. Who?
Allah.
Said, oh Allah, I want to thank you. فتبسم ضاحكا من قولها وقال ربي أوزعني أن أشكر. Oh Allah, can you help me? Can you guide me to do something you like? I want to show you that I'm grateful for this. That you made me understand the language of the birds. That I can hear an ant speaking. You know, an ant, little small thing speaking. And I know what the ant is saying. And the ant and the rest of the ants have so much respect for me. You know, they said they are not going to stampede you while they know, because we're so little, they are going to do this while they don't know, they don't recognize it. Imagine right away Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided him to go and check on his army, and he did not see the hippo, he did not see the hudhud. What happened to the hudhud? What happened to the hippo? The hippo decided to fly far away from Jerusalem. That's where Prophet Sulaiman was, Quds, a place called Palestine, where Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa is, the third holy mosque in Islam. So the bird, the hudhud, decided to fly all the way to a place called Yemen in the south. It would take you 1 hour to fly with an aeroplane now, to go from Jerusalem to Yemen, 1 hour. But when the bird, the hudhud, arrived Yemen, he looked down and he saw something that he did not like at all. Ah. He saw the people there bowing down and praying and worshipping the created. They were supposed to worship who?
Allah.
Worship who?
Allah.
We're supposed to worship who? The Creator. The Creator. We're supposed to worship who? Allah. Who's Allah? The Creator. We're supposed to worship who? Say, the Creator. We're supposed to worship who? But those people in Yemen, they were worshiping what? The created. They were worshiping what? The created. Meanwhile, we must worship who? The Creator, the one who created everything. But the people in Yemen, they were worshiping the sun. Yeah, the sun. They used to pray to the sun. Imagine this. They used to worship the sun beside Allah. And Allah giving them all type of good things. All type of good things. Allah blessed them. giving them water, giving them food, giving them wealth, and yet instead of praying to the worshiping the Creator, they worshiped who?
The
is the Son created or not?
No.
The Son is not created. Who created the Son?
Allah.
Who created the Son?
Allah.
So should I worship the Son or the one who created the Son? Who created the Son? So this Hudhud, he went up, and as soon as he saw this, he said, Astaghfirullah! Astaghfirullah! This is haram! This is haram! Allah giving those people all this type of good things. They are strong, they have money, they have food, they have water. Allah giving them all of these good things. And instead of worshipping Allah, they are worshipping who? The created. Instead of worshipping the Creator, they are worshipping who? The created. He said, I gotta do something about it. I'm a little bird, what I'm gonna do? I'm a little bird. They can't even understand me. So he right away, he said, I'm going to go back to Prophet King Sulaiman and I will tell him what I saw. So he came back. As soon as he arrived, he was told that Prophet Sulaiman is so angry at you because Prophet Sulaiman came earlier and he took an absence. And you were absent and you're in a big trouble. He said, actually, he may slay you. He may slaughter you. He right away went to Prophet Sulaiman. I said, please, he was shaking. Please, just listen to me before you hurt me, please, please. Where you been? Where you been, Hudhud? He said, I was flying over this place. Prophet Sulaiman, and alhamdulillah, we're Muslims. We worship the Creator. But I found those people. They are being ruled by a lady, and Shaitan whispered to them that they are worshiping the Created. They are worshiping the Son beside Allah. Shouldn't they be worshipping Allah, who knows what's in the heavens and what's in the earth? And he said something very interesting. The one who brings the food from beneath the ground, because he eats from beneath the ground. Prophet Sulaiman, he said, you know what? I'm not going to believe you. But I'm not going to punish you until I make sure that what you're telling me is correct. Maybe you're telling me this just to tell, you know, to run away from my punishment. I'm going to write a letter. I want you to take that letter back to those people. And I want you to throw that letter in the window of the queen. Make sure that letter goes to the queen straight, no one else. So the Hebu said, how am I going to do this, you know? How can I do that? What is written in that letter? Prophet Sulaiman, he said in that letter, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. That's, you know, it was mentioned in the Quran in Surah. Don't even think about it. If you guys do not become Muslims, I'm coming after you. Alla ta'lu alayya wa'tuni muslimin. You can do this if you have the power. So the bird now, the Hudhud, doesn't know how I'm going to give that letter to the queen. So he kept flying over the palace. How am I going to get that? And he found another Hudhud. So the Hudhud said to him, the other Hudhud, his friend Hudhud, I have an idea. I will go and knock in the window with my peak, and I will open it, then you throw it and it will close again. So they did that. So the queen woke up in the morning, letter. What is this? Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I'm inviting you to be Muslims. I'm calling you to worship the Creator, not the created. I'm Prophet Sulaiman, and you know who I am. Allah has given me a lot of power, and I'm going to use this power to spread Islam on earth. So the queen got so worried. She knows who Prophet Sulaiman is. He's a strong king, a Muslim king. What am I going to do? What am I going to do? So she called upon her helpers, the generals. What should I do? Right away, they said to her, listen, Prophet Sulaiman has a lot of power. We can fight him. But let's send him a gift. You know what a gift here meaning? You know what a bribery is? You know what a bribery is? Do you guys know what a bribery is? Anybody knows what a bribery is? That you give somebody something in order not to ask you anymore. Like, if we send to him some, let's send to him gold. Let's collect a lot of gold, a lot of silver. Then we're going to give him that, so he leaves us alone. He doesn't ask us to give up the worship of the sun. We can still worship the sun, worship the created, because we like that. So let's just collect some silver, some gold, some money. They filled bags of gold and silver, and they carried it. They carried it to Prophet Sulaiman. As soon as Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam saw the gold and silver and the money, buckets, huge, did they say, I'm rich now. Right, I'm rich, I have the money. Right, that's all I want. I can do whatever I want to do with this money. I can do whatever I want to do. Who cares about those people? No. Prophet Sulaiman, as soon as he saw the money, he saw the gold, he saw the silver, he said, أَتُمِدُّونَنِي بِمَنْ. You're sending me money. Allah has given me much better what you're giving me. Go back to them and take this money back. I'm not going to accept this bribery. I'm only going to accept them to be Muslims. ارجع إليهم. So he went back. Again, while he was sitting down, he asked the Hudhud, the bird, what was the most fascinating thing you saw about those people? He said, the queen has a throne out of this world. A throne. No throne is like it. Even your throne, Prophet Sulaiman. Your throne is not like her throne. So Prophet Sulaiman had also jinn. You know, the jinn are very quick, very fast. So he asked the jinn, who can bring me her throne right now? One of them, he said, as soon as you finish that meeting, I will bring the throne to you. So Prophet Sulaiman said, no, Another one spoke and he said, I'll bring it to you in a blink of an eye. Like that. As soon as he twinkled like this, the throne was there. And the queen was there. So he asked her, is that how your throne is? She said, yes. I will make a better throne for you. He made a much better throne for her. And she immediately said to him, I do not need no throne. I want to be a Muslim. I want to be a Muslim like you. But I want also my people to be Muslims. So she went back and she invited all her nation, the people of Saba, the people of Yemen, to become Muslims. And all of them started praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And guess who was the reason for them to accept Islam? Who? The reason. Who was the main reason? The main reason. Yes, Allah guided them, but who was the main reason? A bird, the hoopoe, the hoodhood. The hoodhood did it. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought you and me to America. Look at you. We're in America. And I know that the majority of you go to public schools. Yeah, we cannot force people to become Muslims. We can. But we know that they are not Muslims. They worship idols. They worship people. Some of them don't worship anybody. Now, we have a chance to tell them about Islam. Yes, we cannot do like Prophet Sulaiman. Can we? We cannot. Because we don't have the power of Prophet Sulaiman. See, Prophet Sulaiman had enough power to do this. He was in control. But us, we can only do this with kindness. Call people to Islam with kindness. Talk to them about Islam. And the best way is through your character. If they look at you, you see that you're honest. You don't lie. You don't cheat. They will like you. And they want to be like you. Especially if you're good with school too. You see, the Hudhud did a great job in guiding those people to Islam. You also can guide many people to Islam in your small circle. In your small circle. This is the story of tonight. Now, I'm going to ask you a couple of questions. And please, no collective answers. No collective answers. I want you to raise your hand. Question number one. What is the name of the Prophet? Who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the ability to understand the language of the birds. Okay, I want you to put your hands down. And before you raise your hands next time, I want you to take 10 seconds to think. Whoever raises his hand before 10 seconds will be excluded. Don't raise your hands right away. So while I'm asking the questions, I'm going to get that candy out for everybody. Oh man, this is nice. Oh, look at this purple. Yeah. That's purple. So what is the name? Back, please, back. Don't come near. What is the name of the bird who told Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam about the people who worship the created, not the creator. Okay, 10 seconds are over now. You may raise your hand. Anybody who raises his hand before the 10 seconds, put it down because I'm not going to pick you.
I put it down.
ارجع ورا. احمد. ارجع ورا. That's my boy, you know. This is, you can tell that he's pushing me. ارجع ورا عبد الرحمن. Okay, young man here. Huh? Speak up. Hood, hood. Hood, hood. Hood, hood. What is his name in English? Hubbu. 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 Okay, here you go. Okay, girls. Brothers, don't look at the girls. Hey, hey, don't look at the girls. Look at me. Nobody looks at the girls. Eyes on me. Don't look at the girls. Okay. ارجع ورا عبد الرحمن. انا جد والله هضرب. بقول لك ايه يالا ولا. What is the name of the place where the hubbu, the hudhud, went to? Are you a girl? I'm supposed to ask the girls. Are you a girl? Whoever raises his hand, are you a girl? You're a man, man. You're a man, man. I'm asking them to go. You're a man, man. You're a man. All right. Okay. Okay. Shukriya. Huh? Who?
Yami.
Who is Yami? Can you say it again?
Yemen.
Yemen. Here you go, Shukriya. Give it to her, please. Okay, third question. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ارجع ورا. ما فيش. ارجع ورا يا ابني. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the birds worship Allah without any choice. There are only two creations of Allah who do have the choice. So everybody around you, the sun, the moon, the sky, the heavens, the earth, the trees, the mountains, the water, the oceans, the rivers, they worship Allah. Who is given the choice to worship or not to worship? Only two of Allah's creations. You need to name them. Okay, go ahead.
Stuff?
Okay, yes. Who? Dogs, even dogs, they worship Allah, by the way. All the animals. They worship all the animals, all the birds, all the fish, the water in the ocean, the water in the river, the sun, the moon, the sky, the trees, the sharks. Everyone worships Allah. Only two of Allah's creation, they can worship
Allah
or not. They can choose to worship or not. Some of them worship, some of them don't. I want you to name them. Huh? Okay. Sumaya. Can you speak up, please? The who? The human and the jinn. The human beings, you and me, and another race called the jinn. The race of Satan. سنفرغ لكم أيها الثقلان. Here you go. Oh, sorry, Sheikh Batar. Sorry, I almost hit you. I almost hit you. Okay. But here is a very smart question. You know, whoever answers this question, I'll give him three. This question is going to take thinking. If you raise your hand like this, that means you don't know the answer. But if you take at least 30 seconds to think about the answer, that means you're thinking about it. Remember when Prophet Sulaiman was passing by the ants? And the ants were afraid that the army will what? Then they said, the queen ants, the leading ants said, okay ants, let's go down to our holes. Come on, Sulaiman and his army are going to step on us. While they don't know, because we're so little, so small, they don't see us. Who heard her? Prophet Sulaiman. And he made dua. What was the dua? What was his dua? What dua? Which dua did he make? Which supplication? He asked Allah for something. What was the supplication? You know? No, you don't have to say the exact words. Stand up. Go ahead. To prove what? For what? You're right. Huh? I'm pure. Takbir! Say takbir! I want to hear Allah. Takbir! I'm so excited. Takbir! The boys are much better than the girls. The girls do want to say takbir! Okay, boys, let me just hear the girls, please. Girls, takbir. Don't look at the girls, man. Look at me, man. Don't look at the girls. Don't look at the girls, man. Come on, man. Look, eyes on me. Eyes on me, man. Eyes on me. Lower your gaze. We should lower our gaze. Okay, girls did great. Let's see the boys. Takbir. What do you think, Sheikh Mutahir?
Close.
Close. Okay, let's try the girls one more time. Girls. No, I didn't say takbir yet, did I? Takbir. Okay, boys. Takbir. Very close. You know what? What's your name?
Nadim.
Nadim? Adib. Can you come shake my hands, man? You did great. You did great. Jazakallah khaira. How old are you? MashaAllah, you get, pick up your three. Pick up the three. Get back. Anybody who touches the table is not going to get any candy tonight. Okay, pick up three. So Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam asked Allah, oh Allah, subhanAllah, I can't understand the language of the birds and these, the language of the animals, of the ants. And these ants, they like me. They know that I won't hurt them knowingly. Now, O Allah, can you give me a good deed so that I can show how grateful I am to you? What deed did Prophet Sulaiman do? What was the best deed that Allah guided Prophet Sulaiman to? Whoever answers that question will get three candies. What was the good deed that Allah has guided Prophet Sulaiman to do? What did he do, Prophet Sulaiman? Back. Okay, who wanna try here? Do you know the answer, Ahmed? Ahmed, go ahead and know the answer. Do you know the answer? What was the answer? Yes. Stand up. Go ahead. What was the deed?
The bird went to the queen.
No, what was the final outcome of the whole story? What happened? At the very end, what happened?
They turned into Muslims.
Takbir! He got it. He guided the good deed that Allah wanted Prophet Sulaiman to do is to help the people of Yemen to be Muslims. So this is the best deed that you can do. So if you want to show yourself, show that you're grateful to Allah, the best thing that you can do is what? Guide somebody to Islam. Help somebody to become a Muslim. Go ahead, please. Come on. Quickly, quickly. Quickly, quickly. Hurry up. Come on. Oh. No, no, no. Hurry up. From here. Sit down now. One more. Come on. Sit down now. Sit down. Okay. Okay. Back up. Back up a little bit. Back up. Back up. Back up. Okay. We have enough candy for everybody. Okay. Here is one more question. One more question. The people of Yemen thought that Prophet Sulaiman wants money. He wants gold. He doesn't care whether we're Muslims or not. For him, this is not important. So let's send to him some money. Did Prophet Sulaiman accept this money? Did he accept the money?
No!
What did he do?
Oh.
Okay. Shh. That's the question. Raise your hand. We need a sister now. Sit down. We need a sister. Eyes on me, man. Look at this. Looking at the sisters. Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah. Looking at the sister. Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah, ya Rajil. Astaghfirullah, ya Am. Ya Am, astaghfirullah, ya Am. He's looking at the sisters. Yes, go ahead. Okay, Sarah, go ahead. I don't want your money. Allah has given me more than what you're giving me. Here you go. Okay, you know what? Let's call it off now. It's 7:30 because I want to take you to the gym to play a little bit. So what we're going to do.